Hey guys, thanks for watching Beyond Science. It's Mike Chen. This is a video topic that a lot of you have sent in for me to talk about, so thank you so much for doing that. And before we get into it, I just wanna give a shout out to the sponsor of the video, Top Hatter, and I'll talk about that more at the end of the video. Now, disease, famine, climate control, runaway asteroids, Kim Jong-un. These are just some of the ways humanity can get wiped off from the face of the planet. And the thing is, even though we do talk about it, I don't think anybody really believes that it could actually happen, or at least happen anytime soon. But, and I'll say the word extinction, after all, is an inevitable part of nature, and really no single species is safe from it, not even us. And I don't know about you guys, but this year especially feels like the apocalyptic train is at least picking up speed with all the earthquakes, hurricanes, crazy people just killing for no good reason. Again, Kim Jong-un being, you know, Kim Jong-un. I don't know, it just feels like that the world could end any day now. But regardless of whether it's the robot apocalypse, the zombie apocalypse, or whatever else our eventual grisly end may be, one thing is for sure. Unless the Earth is just completely annihilated, Mother Nature will continue to live on without the human race. So in today's video, we're going to talk about what happens if suddenly we all disappear. So in the event that we became extinct, within just a few hours of humanity's disappearance, the entire world will go dark. Like, literally. Well, of course, more at night, because there will be no one left to keep the power plants running and the generators going. So one by one, every single bulb, every neon light, every street lamp will go dark as power begins to shut down around the world, plunging the globe in darkness. Again, this is at night. In the daytime, of course, it really won't make much of a difference. Then comes the nuclear chain reaction. With all the power finally going out, there's going to be a mass chain reaction of nuclear meltdowns from every single power plant in each nuclear-powered country. Because without power keeping these plants' cooling systems operational, these plants will begin to melt down within a month, and the following explosions will be much stronger and much deadlier. Well, not to us because we're already dead, but to the animals and maybe the zombies are still left behind. But the explosions will be way worse than the combined meltdowns of Fukushima and Chernobyl. After that, the floods will appear in just a few days after we're gone. First, our underground railways and tunnels will be flooded and completely submerged because the pumps that divert water and sewage from the tunnels will stop operating and begin to fill up until it eventually spills into our underground infrastructures. And speaking of sewage, since everything has already shut down, sewage treatment plants will also cease to operate. That will later on spill out of drains and start, and this is disgustingly horrifying, it will start a flood of sewage that will most definitely poison existing plants and animals. So death by a tsunami of poo, maybe not the greatest thing. But the worst is still to come, because after the poo, we've got the falling stars. Well, not exactly stars, because within a year of our extinction, the skies will be a sight to behold as one by one, all the satellites that we have launched into space will start plummeting back to Earth, having no means of being powered and maintained. And the sight will most likely resemble a meteor shower with streaks of light illuminating the night sky. Of course, we won't be around to see it. Then comes the part that's kind of sad. Well, I mean, it is sad that we've all become extinct, but this is really sad. Only a few weeks after our sudden extinction, many of our domesticated animals and pets will begin to die, because most likely many of our furry and feather friends will be locked up in our homes or in their cages or in barns when the human race dies out. And without having anyone to attend to them, these animals that we have bred for our leisure or enterprise will most likely not survive, because they would have no means to sustain or feed themselves. Now, the smart ones that may find a way out will still have a lot of trouble surviving, because these domestic breeds of pets, especially the smaller ones like your aunt's chihuahua or your frisky little terrier, will probably end up being on the menu of much larger predatory wildlife that may have already encroached upon places that humans used to occupy. Suffice to say that the extinction of humanity may also be the extinction of, I don't know, the little Taco Bell guy. And speaking of animals, when the massive cities that we have built and the suburbs that we have occupied have been devoid of our presence, animal life will begin to return to these places they used to call home before we moved in. A good example of this scenario in a microcosm is Chernobyl. When the area was turned into a no man's land after the devastating meltdown of its nuclear power plant, wildlife and even vegetation returned to the region. Wild dogs and birds have returned to begin begin bringing back life, albeit, I mean, they're radioactive and highly contaminated lives, but still lives. And speaking of our houses and buildings and skyscrapers, over time, structures, especially those that are made of steel, will crumble and collapse. Monuments like the Eiffel Tower and structures such as the Golden Gate and Brooklyn Bridges will practically disintegrate due to rust and zero maintenance. And as vegetation slowly creeps in to retake the land, concrete structures would also break apart as roots and vines force their way into a structure's cracks and crannies. Perhaps the only man-made monuments that will last for a while after we're gone may be our monuments made out of stone, such as the Great Pyramids of Giza and the Great Wall of China. But then soon after that, water will start filling up the world, well, even more. At the height of mankind's expansion of territories and the great discoveries of new lands, we have paved ways to new regions by building dams and forcing water out of places where they should be. Delta cities, man-made islands, and places where water has been diverted to create a hospitable place for us to live will be swept away by the very same elements we have tried to command. Without anyone to maintain them, dam walls, no matter how thick and fortified, will break and release, well, a lot of water. When it does, tons of land will be submerged, turning them back into the rivers and swamplands that they used to be. Bodies of water, such as the Colorado River, will once again flow into the Gulf of Mexico, and the Hoover Dam will crumple to give back the river that it kept contained for decades. Now, the thing is, not only will water flow everywhere, deserts will also expand. When we're all gone, the cities we have built in desert lands, such as Las Vegas and Dubai, will turn back into deserts, with only the monuments that we have built and the structures that we have put up as ghosts of what was once our flourishing civilizations. These desert cities will be nothing more than just arid landscapes against the blazing backdrop of the sun. Even massive areas in the Western Hemisphere, such as Mexico and California, will turn back to the parched landscapes that they used to be as homes and buildings begin to deteriorate and the heat from the sun dries up the land once more. And finally, Mother Nature takes it all back. Within just 2 decades of our extinction, Mother Nature will fully reclaim the Earth as vegetation will return and spread. Despite the fact that humankind was able to cultivate certain species of vegetation to make it more edible, but without us, it will return back to its natural state, and many of the plants and vegetables we all know and see in our plates, they will virtually be unrecognizable in their true wild states. The Earth, upon our extinction and because of the return of a bunch of vegetation, the air will drastically change. It'd be much cleaner than it ever was because all the pollutants will be absorbed, processed, and basically cleansed by plants. Eventually, this will clear up the Earth's atmosphere and restore it to a pure state once again. So all this will happen in decades, and this is why I strongly believe that once ancient advanced civilizations existed on Earth, which would explain a lot of things, like maybe how the pyramids were constructed or who built Stonehenge. I mean, everything I talked about right here in this video happens in a few decades, so why couldn't an ancient advanced civilization have existed and built a lot of stuff, but somehow died off and over thousands of years have been completely covered up by nature. Also, as I was doing this video, I was thinking, maybe in the future, you know, once we can live on Mars, we should just all leave for like 100 years and just let the Earth recover. And then, you know, come back and destroy it again. All right, guys, hopefully you enjoyed this video. Also, like I mentioned in the beginning, this video is in partnership with Top Hatter. And if you don't know, Top Hatter is a website with one of the world's fastest and most entertaining marketplace. And it's entertaining because they have live online auctions every single day offering lots of awesome items. Basically, you go on the site and there are new and unique items every single time you visit, and you bid on these things live in auctions that last about 90 seconds. Or you can become a seller and get access to over 12 million users. Anyway, I tried this myself and I'll just say, yeah, it's pretty addictive. I don't think I've ever been so worked up buying a pair of headphones before. Definitely check them out. And if you use the link below, you'll get $5 off your next purchase of $6 or more, including shipping from Top Hatter. So please use my link www.tophatter.com/offer/beyondscience. You'll get to experience a cool site and you're helping this channel. So win-win. And guys, like I mentioned, this was a topic sent in by a lot of you. So keep sending me those topics. Leave them in the comments below. Facebook me, email me. Let me know what you want me to talk about. Again, thank you all so much for watching. See you later.